Hey guys, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Today we're going to talk about how to find the area under a curve using integration. So the goal of this lesson is, let's say we have a curve on the Cartesian plane. So this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. Let's say we have a curve like this one. And we wanted to find the area from the y-axis all the way to, let's say, somewhere here. Let's say we wanted to find out this shaded area here, how we can do that using integration. Okay, so now that's going to be a bit complicated to start off with that. So let's just start off with a very simple graph. So let's say we have a Cartesian plane, x on the horizontal, y on the vertical, and let's draw a very simple straight line equation where we have y equals x. Right, just a very simple straight line graph, and I'm going to label the axes as well. So the x-axis, let's say we have 1, 2, 3. Vertical axis, I also have 1, 2, 3. And you can see that, let's say I wanted to find the area under the curve, well, in this case, a straight line between x is 1 to x is 3. So let's say I wanted to find this shaded area. And, well, let's not use any integration techniques at the moment. Let's just find the area using a simple area of a triangle rule. So the area of a triangle is simply base times height divided by 2, isn't it? Now that's pretty simple math from, I don't know, junior maths, so you should be able to know that. So area of a triangle is the base, in this case is 3 centimeters or millimeters or whatever units you want to define it as, 3. And the height of the triangle is also 3. So it's 3 times 3 divided by 2, which is 9 divided by 2, which is 4.5. Now that's finding the area without any integration techniques. Now, firstly, what we want to do is integrate this equation. Right, so to find the area under the curve, in this case, a straight line to find this area, the first thing we want is to integrate the equation. So our original equation is x. So let's find the integral of x. And because we want to find out the area from x is 0 to x is 3, we're going to put these two coordinates, 0 and 3, next to the integral sign. So I'm going to put 0 down the bottom and 3 at the top. And now this becomes the definite integral. Now, what this means is we're going to find the area under the curve of the equation x between position 0 and position 3 for x. So the definite integral from 0 to 3 of x dx is equal to, and now we're just going to integrate the equation in the middle, and if you remember how to integrate, we just write x squared over 2 using the integration formula. And now we're going to write 3 at the top and 0 at the bottom. Now what that means is I'm going to substitute the number 3 first into the equation. So I'm going to substitute 3 squared over 2. And then I'm going to minus, and I'm going to substitute the number 0 into the formula, 0 squared over 2. So now what does this become? 3 squared over 2 is 9 over 2. Minus 0 squared over 2 is just 0. So the answer is 4.5 again. So now we have just found the area under the curve. So we found this area here using integration. Now you might ask, how does this method work? I mean, how is it that if you integrate something that it gives you the formula for the area under a curve? Well, if you want to see a full proof of that, you should probably watch another video on it, and I think I'll make that video soon. But usually in high school, you wouldn't be asked to provide a proof as to how an integral of an equation gives you the area under the curve. So you don't have to worry about the proof in the test, but if you're interested in finding out how it works, I should be making a video on it sometime in the future. But for now, just understand that if you integrate an equation, you end up with the formula that gives you the area under the curve. So that's pretty useful. So now let's try integrate a more complicated equation to find the area under the curve. Okay, so I've just drawn a very simple graph in GeoGebra, a very simple curve. And let's say I want to find the area under the curve between x is 1 and x is 3. So I want to know this whole area here. Alright. So what we would do now is we will integrate from definite integral from x is 1 to 3 of negative x squared plus 4x minus 1 dx. Right, so we're going to find the integral of that. And let's use the integration formula. So we have negative x cubed over 3 plus 4x squared over 2 minus x. And we're going to put the number 3 at the top, 1 at the bottom. So we're going to substitute number 3 into the formula first. So we have negative 3 cubed. And notice how when the formula is set up that way, we're going to cube it first before we put the negative on it. Over 3 plus 4 times 3 squared over 2 minus 3 minus, and then now we substitute the number 1 into it. So negative 1 cubed over 3 plus 4 times 1 squared over 2 minus 1. Okay, so now let's try to do it by hand first instead of typing it all in the calculator. So we have negative 27 over 3 plus 4 times 9 is 36 over 2 minus 3 minus 1 cubed is 1, negative 1 over 3 plus 4 over 2 minus 1. So this is all now just yet 5 math, I guess. So we have negative 9 plus 18 minus 3 minus just gonna type it in the calculator now, and the answer is 5 1/3. So if you have a look at our graph, and you can sort of mentally check whether it makes sense by just looking at the graph, because let's say we divide up this into a rectangle, a square and a triangle. So let's say we divide this area up into a little squared. Oops, let me make it darker. So let's say I divide this area up into a square here. So then we have 2 by 2, which is 4 units squared for, let's say, centimeters. And then this little bit here, let's say we convert it into a little triangle. Right, so we have 2 on the bottom. So we have 2 centimeters on the bottom, the height is 1 centimeter, so 2 by 1 is 2 divided by 2 is 1, so it is about 5. And the extra bit, the 5 1/3, that could come from this little bit that wasn't included in my triangle. Alright, so you sort of gotta mentally check whether the area makes sense. Okay, well, thanks guys for watching the tutorial on how to find the area under a curve. This is for solving the most basic problem only. There will be other problems where you might need to use some more complicated techniques, but we'll talk about that later. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.